Salutations, good people. My name is Rachel Kay, and this is The Event Show. So some of the highlights of the show are the event that we covered for you, Koroga Music Festival, which happened at the Arboretum Grounds. Following up will be music and movie reviews of the day, plus a one-on-one with the legendary DJ, DJ Kalonje. We also have a new segment for you, and that is the postcard. Share your views and comments on our social media. Like our page on Facebook, The Event Show. Follow us on Twitter at The Event Show, and on Instagram, The Events _ Show. Tune in for this and much more.
What's up, good people? Today, The Event Show is right here at Koroga Music Festival at the Arboretum Grounds, where Kofi Olomide is going to make his performance tonight. I really can't wait. And as you can see, people are still streaming in, despite the fact that the turn-up is amazing. The numbers have turned up today is amazing. So guys, keep it locked here as you see more on the event and more on The Event Show.
Player 45 2B DJ Mopao Frontiere Aliwa
Karanga photo
Tutu Roba
Amiyo Amiyo Chuma Amiyo
Baby Oya Kobina Te Amon and Zambi Te Oya Kobina Te
Amo Christo Te
Ah Jésus Seigneur
Seigneur Bien
Ahmed Bakayoko, l'homme du peuple.
Amiyo, Chuma, Amiyo,
Mila Lovis Topé.
Allez t'improviser.
Jean-François Ndenge.
Ndenge Lovis Topé.
Demo.
Allez t'improviser.
So what's your name?
My name is Akisa Madenge, and I have a collection called Wangari Madenge, and I specialize in making ponchos, African ponchos. So what I do is I specialize with Maasai shuka, and also I use kitenge. So that's what I've been doing for now.
So how is it going for you in the Kenyan industry?
Well, it's a bit hard because I feel like you have to work harder when it comes to penetrating the market. But so far so good. Well, I've started exhibiting, so that's cool.
So why did you choose to showcase your collection at the Koroga Festival?
Well, my friend is the one who actually recommended for me to come because she was like, your stuff is so cool because I like the diversity that I'm seeing at Koroga. And I'm glad because I've already sold a few things. Because most of my clients are like, my stuff a bit dramatic. And yeah, so far so good. I like Koroga. I'm definitely coming back again. Yeah.
I must say, your collection is amazing. So what are your expectations today?
Well, selling more and more stuff, getting guys to know more about who I am. So you can follow me on Facebook, Wangari Madenge, on Instagram, Wanga Madenge, Twitter, Wanga Madenge.
Yeah. And what if I want to purchase your product other than from this event?
Oh, well, I have a website, wangarimadenge.com, where you can purchase it online. Or you can, from my website, there's my contacts, even on Facebook. If you inbox me, I can be able to
get it. Ego DJ, Ego DJ, Frank, Ego DJ. Martin Chamoules,
Yamaya Brazil, Yamaya Bari, Dalanyo, Yamaya Braza.
Wait, who is Katumbi?
Ego Dide, Ego Dide, Ego Dide, Ego Dide, Ego Dide,
Ego Dide, Chaleur 45 2B, DJ Mopao, Frontière et Aliwa.
Karanga photo.
Tutu Roba.
Amio. Amio. Tchouma, Amio.
Et dis moi la combinaté, à moi l'anzambité. Voilà la combinaté,
à mon Christoté.
I'm here with Jesus Tony Sinier from Why Not Barbecue. Tony, how is the event so far?
Great event. Koroga has always been a great event, and this time it hasn't disappointed either. We're all here waiting for Kofi.
So tell me a little bit about Why Not Barbecue.
Well, Why Not is it's a small outfit. We do barbecues. What Why Not is trying to do is revolutionize barbecuing, and we do barbecues at people's houses, at any event that any event you call us at. So basically it's all about barbecue meat. Yeah.
So apart from this event, is there anywhere else people can get these delicious pieces of chicken?
Yes, if you take my number down there, you can call me. I can do it at your house. I can do it at any location. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
hope you enjoyed Kofi Olomide's performance at the Koroga Music Festival. Coming right up is our movie and music review of the day. Keep it locked here. Welcome to our movie and music reviews of the day. We'll kick off with the movie reviews, starting with Where to Invade Next. Now this, Michael Moore gives people here a burst of optimism. Another brilliant documentary, just like any other documentary he has ever made. This guy is making the world better with every movie he makes, and hopefully our next generation can learn as much as we can from this amazing man. In this movie, he visits various countries to examine how Europeans view work, education, healthcare, equality, and other issues. Through his travels, you discover just how different America is from the rest of the world. Now, moving on to the next movie, Conclusion. The people who were criticizing this and giving it bad reviews have no heart, it seems like. If you're a fan of sports or not, this movie deserves credit, especially the fact that Will Smith stars in this one. The movie stars Will Smith as Dr. Benet Omalu, a forensic pathologist who fought against efforts by the National Football League to support his research on brain damage suffered by professional football players. And hey, so what if his voice doesn't sound exactly like a Nigerian accent? He did an amazing job nonetheless. It's such a sad and amazing film at the same time, and that's why it's a must watch. Everyone should stop whining about Will Smith's accent when what matters most is the message in this movie. Now moving on to the last movie review of the day, Burnt. Bradley Cooper here stars in the drama about a brilliant but troubled chef looking for a shot at redemption. This one might leave you hungry for a meal, or you possibly be hard pressed to afford money-wise, and if that food exists at all. Leave it to Hollywood to try and make a movie about cooking a suspenseful thriller by using a bunch of edgy buzzwords in the trailer and dramatic music undertones. Absolutely funny. As you watch this movie, you'll notice that it packs some minor surprises and attractive details along its way. Now moving on to our music reviews of the day, we will kick off with Kendrick Lamar's Untitled and Mastered. The Compton rapper's return is unexpected, explosive, and very, very brilliant. After a year of artistic triumph, Kendrick Lamar delves deeper into his thoughts and anxieties on an album that is anything but a lazy victory rap. Few people predicted a new Kendrick Lamar album would come so quickly after March 2015's Big To Pimp A Butterfly. A record so great popular opinion suggested its sheer quality had delayed Kanye West's album, The Life of Pablo. Our next music review of the day is Get Your Hand In My Hand by Hotel Lights. Now the songwriter in this album, Jesse, clearly has the songwriting chops to occasionally create a legitimately great song, but he often seems to settle for good enough, if you ask me. That makes Get Your Hand In Mine an easy album to listen to. But the general lack of variety in style and tempo ensures that the song starts in to become background noise if one is not wholly on the music. Third and final music review of the day is Heaven Adores You by Elliot Smith. Now this album helps us search for our own emotions, our sadness, and level it all out. It has the ability to wed identifiable and original timing with the warmness of a distant friend catching you up on a painful moment of their life, all the while believing a silver lining may eventually form. Rarities, live tracks, and well-known favorites come together on the soundtrack to the latest documentary of Elliot Smith's stellar career. That's all for our music and movie review of the day. Keep it locked here for more on the show. Despite Will Smith's accent, I still insist that Conclusion is a really amazing movie. I hope you enjoyed our music and movie review of the day. We will go on a short break, and when we'll be back, I'll tell you more about our new segment. Don't touch that dial. Welcome back, and like I promised, we'll bring you our new segment, which is the postcard, where you as our viewers and anyone else in the arts and entertainment industry can come and talk to us on the show in 5 questions, after which we'll also bring you the one-on-one that we had with the legendary DJ Kalonje. Keep it locked here to know what he had to tell us on the show.
me touch ya. You feel it, me like ya. You want me, me got ya. Okay, match black, give me the track then. Kerji, I'm better than them. First crush, we hotter than them. All streets, we fly above them. Them a free, cause guns, we love them. Kerji, I'm better than them. First crush, we hotter than them. All streets, we fly above them. Them a free, cause guns, we love them. Mini yule bad boy, toke ya na. Nimekuja kuwacha pampaka wawike. Tuna roll, killer time. Everything me own, Jaja gave me. You better salute when you see me. None of them can touch, Jah protect me. Anyway, well you don't know this is KRT, they don't aka the dancehall lobos, you see me? They are representing the first Christian music, you see me? I also do business, do drugs, so that's transport business, and also fashion, fashion design, left those are on my own business. It was the same to me when I was starting, but luckily I got my parents back and my family. So,
you can see this one is a killer, you can call emergency. Me can fit take my crown and me the money.
We are comfortable, you can't say we are rich. Yeah. Above them, it has done quite well. And also new track that we're going to release soon. I know we'll take away the next level.
Can you give us a hint about the names of the tracks or what
it
will
be about? Track we are about to release. We are doing the video right now. We have just done some parts. It's called Step. It's coming to step up the whole place. Money that I'm my way. Can't waste them like the bad mind them. Lobos Wear, it's a cool urban design that's fit anybody. Like, you don't have to be. Today is like a weekday for I don't feel like it's so like left out. When you wear logos, you're not left out in any occasion. So you can put on any day, any time, going to any event. You can even go and meet the president when you're dressed in logos. Never taken time to go and start calculating what I have. I'm looking for it. I don't have, so I don't have that time to go and sit and start counting what I have. If you look out first cash music, the whole of family they will come to take over the whole music scene in 254. Zin, like the whole place. Mike Black, big up in yourself, Prof, big up yourself, Bandana, Luther, our prophet. The general himself, Zin Maurice, Arrow Boy, big up on yourself.
Welcome to the show. I'm here with the legend himself, DJ Kalonje. Karibu, thank you for coming here.
Thanks, Anna.
Yeah, Tuambia, how's your year been so far, 2016?
My year has been good. Yeah, I started off from international tour. Dubai, I went to Qatar, then I went to Bahrain.
Excuse me, from local to international. So Kalonje is your real name?
No, actually my real name is George Wawero.
Yeah. Okay, so tell us like why you chose that particular name and hand in hand that career that you're doing right now.
Kalonje was a nickname from high school. Back in high school, I used to be the entertainment captain. And I used to issue out CDs in the entertainment scene. And it happened that There's an artist who was named Sizzla Kalonji at that time, who was really banging at that time.
Kenyan artist?
No, he's actually Jamaican.
Oh, okay.
And from there, people started calling me Kalonji there. When I started DJing, I decided to call my name, call myself that name.
So you started DJing in high school?
Yeah, from 3, from 4.
And how did you get to practice? Because I understand most high schools don't have the DJ facilities.
It's just a matter of patience and high school. Maybe at the weekends, I'd go to clubs and ask for a DJ for a ride. And when extra hours when I'm not in class, I'd make time and go to the clubs and get some tutorials for DJing.
Okay, so generally, tell us, who is DJ Kalonji?
DJ Kalonji basically is an entertainer. Yes.
Just an entertainer.
Entertainer from Kenya. A versatile entertainer who has been entertaining for almost now a decade, and he also runs a company called Mixmasters Entertainment, which deals with entertainment provision and of course also DJ school. Yeah.
So you do DJing full-time?
I'm also an entrepreneur.
Okay, great. And on that note, tell us something about your roots, something that day-to-day you relate with your current career, like how you grew up, who day you make wase onyo, make ujenga, and all that.
Mimi nimezaliwa Sili, number 9.
Route 9.
Then tukamia Gedo. Yeah, and my family has also been very supportive. Yeah, my family, my friends have also been very supportive. It has not been a great, a soft journey, but it has been great so far.
Okay, so how did you start off? When was your breakthrough as a DJ?
Actually, I was DJing for a while. I started DJing in 2005, but in 2006, 2010, I scooped the Chaguo Latinis Award, and that was a very big breakthrough because I was competing with my mentors, Akina Pinye, Akina Styles, and I actually outdid them and I scooped the Chaguo Latinis, and I also did that in 2011, and I think that is where my breakthrough was.
Okay, so what can you think that you did differently from other DJs that made you stand out? Or what are you doing differently so that we get the opportunity to hear DJ Kalonji everywhere and not any other DJ?
First of all, my marketing platform is a bit different because where I started from, I didn't start from any media, any TV station or any radio. I started off from the Matatus, and that was my platform. So far, apart from that, also my mixes are a bit special because I take time to create my mixtape because I consider every mixtape of mine as a masterpiece. Yeah.
Okay, so what's your driving force? What gives you the energy to get up and go on doing what you're doing every day?
The love of music, of course.
Anything else like friends, family?
Definitely, yes, yeah. yes. Also my family and friends, but mostly the love and the passion of music. Because if you love what you do, even if you have obstacles and stuff like that, you still have to try and overcome them to continue doing what you love.
Okay, and does DJing pay?
Yes, it does.
Like really pay?
Of course it does, but of course it also depends on your hustle and how you brand yourself. Yeah, DJing is a very paying career, especially right now in Kenya because the entertainment industry in Kenya is really growing.
It's picking up.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you only do DJ full time, you're comfortable with it. What would you tell someone who's struggling to be who Kalonji is?
I'd tell him to try and find, as much as he wants to be a DJ, doesn't, he should not really like copy me 100%. He should try and find his own path as a DJ because it will not make any sense having a mix that sounds the same as Kalonji, like I le mix in a kaka ya Kalonji. But as a DJ, I'd just tell him to focus, put God first, and always persevere in everything that he does.
Oh, nice. So where do you see yourself in 5 years from now, from today to day?
5 years?
Yeah.
5 years, basically my company Mix Masters Entertainment, I'm hoping that it will have really grown to be an empire, and of course sharing the stage with big names. We know we have like the biggest DJ in the world. Yeah, we have like David Guetta, Calvin Harris, and those guys. Yeah, yeah, sharing a stage with them will be really nice.
That's what you would want to do in 5 years. And I'm sure the ladies would want to know, is Kalonje taken? Am I still in the market?
Kalonje unfortunately is taken for now. Yes.
You heard it, ladies, too bad. So finally, tell us something that no blogger has known about you before, something that has not been in the media about you. It can be professional or personal.
I was a hawker, basically, before I became a DJ. I was a hawker because I used to give out my CDs in matatus and stuff. So kwa jam, sa zile kabla traffic ifunguke, nikuwa po kwa badirisha na uzama CD.
And people used to buy?
Yeah, that is where I started.
Where it all started before you started mainstreaming in matatus. Ah, nice. So give us your last words, anything that you'd want to share with your fans out there.
I just want to thank my fans for the big support they've been giving me. And of course, we're going far together. And I also want to thank you, Rachel, for the interview.
Welcome.
And also big up the camera guys, wako huko nyuma. Hakuna mtu anaona, but shukran for the great job.
Thank you for coming to our show. There you heard it, guys, from the legend himself, DJ Kalonje. You know what you have to do to be that legend too. We have come to the end of another exciting and, of course, entertaining edition of the Events Show. I hope you enjoyed our lineup together with our guests that you heard on the show, on our postcard carrier, Jide Don, and on our one-on-one, DJ Kalonje. If you wish to be part of our postcard, just like I mentioned before, be sure to follow us on our social media platforms where you can also share your views and comments on our Facebook page, The Events Show, Twitter at The Events Show, and on Instagram at The Events Show. You can also watch our previous episodes on our YouTube channel, TVC Kenya, The Events Show. Have a blessed week ahead. I've been your host, Rachel K.